I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Hello, and welcome to our show. I'm so glad to be here today to talk to you about some fun things for New Year's Eve. We are at the Highway 138 bottle shop here off of Highway 138 in Stockbridge, and we're going to be talking to Bill about some fun drinks and different things that we can do for New Year's Eve and drink responsibly this year by staying at home with our parties and things of that nature. So let's see if we can find Bill, and he's going to take us on a tour of the store. So let's go find where he may be. Let's see. Bill. Hey, Bill. How are you?
Hey, what's going on? It's so good
to see you.
Well, it's good to be seen.
Yes, I wanted to come and take some time with you. Do you have a few moments that you can share with me?
Oh, yeah.
I wanted to talk about some opportunities for New Year's Eve. We have a lot of viewers that are watching our shows and would like to bring to them some ideas and things that they can have for their New Year's Eve parties. Do you think you can help me out?
Yeah, there's a few ideas floating around this place.
Okay. Well, if you don't mind, where can we get started on some suggestions?
Actually, you're standing in one of the hot spots for our industry, especially during this time of year. Believe it or not, and even I find this hard to believe, all you see on this back wall is vodka.
Vodka, that is one of the beverages that I like myself. So.
A major category, but things have changed over the years. A few years ago, this would have been this brand of vodka.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's down to here, and the reason for that is an explosion
of flavors?
In your choice of flavors.
Right.
Some of these brands have gotten to the point where when you look at them sitting on the shelf, each flavor has a different color. It looks like an explosion in a confetti factory.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah,
well,
really,
and of course, they are delicious, and there are several different ways that you can use these flavored vodkas.
And what's really happening is people are coming up with their own experimental ideas. There's you know, an astronomical possible combination of flavors and products to go with these. And the bartenders are having a field day.
Oh, I bet.
But when you talk about ideas for flavors,
yeah,
if you come up this way,
okay,
we've got what I call our robo bartender.
Okay.
Yeah, this is pretty neat.
Alrighty.
And what this is welcome to the computer age.
Okay.
This is our virtual bartender.
Wow.
If a customer comes in and they're trying to get some ideas, and maybe, you know, we've got customers in here that's got everybody tied up, you can come over here and you can search your own recipes. It'll give you the ingredients you need for something you're researching, and you can even email this to yourself if you don't have a pen.
Wow, that's amazing. So you can come in here with a idea of what you may want to drink.
Sure, you bet.
And then what you can do is come up to the virtual bartender. It says here that you can put in the year you're born. Make sure you're old enough to be able to drink anyway. And then after you put in your year, let's see how this works. Enter. I am a female. And it's going to give me an idea of how I can... Let's see, great cocktails.
Cocktails to party planning, tricks of the trade.
What do I drink? I drink vodka. We'll just use that as an example. And then it gives you all of these ideas, huh?
Hundreds of choices, hundreds of categories, combinations, recipes. You can spend an evening in here just playing with the virtual robo bartender.
And then it can be emailed to you, and when it's emailed,
send
or you can print out the recipe right here.
Print it out or send it to yourself, either way.
Awesome. So whatever the drink may be that you're interested in, you can come and get that recipe and get that information right here. So
times have changed.
Oh, your friends will be so impressed.
In conjunction with that, this section here, this is really the candy of our industry. These are the cordials and liqueurs.
Okay.
And we all know about the hard liquors, but this is where the artistry in our industry is all about.
This doesn't really require a lot of mixing. You can drink these straight. Is that right?
Most of these you can't drink straight, but over the years now, more importantly, these are crucial ingredients to some of the really popular cocktail recipes.
Wow.
Yeah.
They're always keeping it interesting. interesting.
Midori, you've got a rainbow selection of flavors of different schnapps.
This is...
Key lime.
Oh my goodness. Now, you know, does this taste just like the pie?
Close your eyes and imagine Key West, Florida.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay, we better keep rolling here. I may get stuck.
Yeah. And then if you come on down here, these are the creams. The cream liqueurs have always been popular and they continue to grow. There's just no end to it. You can go for 99 bananas.
Oh my goodness.
If you're looking for something different from a cream. But when we get into the traditional, really, you know, Americana of our business, even though we can't call it American, Americans have a big stake in it. The Scotch whiskeys are extremely important to us.
Yep. And you have a huge selection here.
There's more than you can shake a stick at, including what's really important in the Scotch category is the single malt scotches, which continues to be the growth category. And they can be from relatively lightly flavored to extremely heavy, truly an acquired taste. But for the Scotch lover, that's where you want to be, somewhere in this section, the single malts. And in America, we have a corresponding section in the next aisle over, which are the bourbons.
Okay.
There are the standard bourbons, and then there are what we call single barrel bourbons.
Now, when it comes to the bourbon, it's important with the barrel, how long it's in the barrel. Is that right or wrong?
Same is true with Scotch whiskeys.
Okay.
And here, comparable to the single malt scotches, we have single barrel bourbons.
Okay.
And this also is a growth category. Again, within this category, this is where the artistry is involved. These are the blends are put together with meticulous attention to what's coming out of a multitude of barrels. The single barrel bourbons are critically judged on the age and how each individual barrel is developing and when it's time to bottle.
Okay, well, let's take our first commercial break because he has a lot more information for us and to share with us some more ideas for some great drinks for New Year's Eve. So stay tuned and we'll be right back.
Conveniently located just off I-75 in Stockbridge, Highway 138 Package Store offers a huge selection at great prices. Our friendly, knowledgeable staff are available to assist you with hard-to-find items, and you'll find promotional sales and unadvertised specials located throughout the store. We offer mix-and-match case discounts and a VIP club membership with heavily discounted prices on selected items. So come in and browse our selections and let us keep you in good spirits.
I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Okay, welcome back to the show. And Bill has now got me over here in the champagne area. We're going to start talking about some wonderful brands that you have here for New Year's Eve. Of course, you got to have the champagne, got to pop that cork. So tell us, let's talk about some of that you have here.
Yeah, talk about 'tis the season. Funny, it seems to come around every year about this time.
About this time, right after Christmas.
Amazing how that works. Champagnes are, of course, the traditional item for New Year's. And what you'll find here is a selection of the traditional French champagne, which for the most part tend to be what we call dry, which is the opposite of sweet. However, you can find high quality champagnes that are done in a sweeter style, which though more popular in Europe, we are seeing a growing trend in demand for here in the U.S.
Okay, so there are the two different types of champagne are dry and sweet.
Dry versus sweet, and most of the major producers make both.
Okay.
But you do tend to have to look a little harder to find some of the sweeter styles, but we try to always make sure that there's some to be had.
And you can ask him that when you come down for your champagne. Make sure if you want a dry or a sweet, and you may not know which ones are different, then they can help you with that here.
Here's a handy little thing that a lot of people are still discovering, even though it's been going on for a long time. The classic champagne companies in France, true champagne comes from France, and we won't get into all of that.
Okay.
But many years ago, over 20 years ago, most of those major producers also opened up shop in California.
Okay.
So you you can buy high-end champagne from companies like Tattinger and Piper Heidsieck and Moët Chandon from France, but you can also find a less expensive, slightly different style with still world-class quality product from those same companies, a la California.
Mm-hmm.
Domaine Chandon, Domaine Carneros from Tattinger, Piper Sonoma from Piper Heidsieck. They all have a new world cousin these days, usually running about half the price, but still very high quality.
This is not a bad price when you're celebrating New Year's Eve.
Not tacky at all.
Okay, so now Absolutely. We're going to go around to the other side. So where are we at right here?
This is an interesting section, and this will go hand in hand with New Year's. We get a lot of people that these days are looking for, again, sweeter styles, mm-hmm. but also high quality.
Right.
And bubbly or non-bubbly. And what you'll find here are high quality Italian red sparkling wines that a lot of people just think of as red champagne.
Okay.
But they're very fruity, very high quality. And I'll tell you what, if you've got a little something chocolate to put in your mouth and nibble on while you're sipping on this, you're on your way. You're having some fun then.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, these are what we call Bricetta d'Aci, or related wines out of Italy.
Mm-hmm.
Very fruity, red, sweet, bubbly, whole lot of fun.
Wow.
Really
sounds great.
Stuff.
It's very interesting. And you know I love chocolate.
Somebody told me you had a thing going on with chocolate.
I do.
Here's something called Chocolate Shop, which we found earlier this year. I thought it was going to be just a gimmick, but actually it's a pretty classy product. If
wow.
you like chocolate,
uh-huh.
you like cherries,
mm-hmm.
you know the Whitman sampler where there's always a couple of those chocolates that's got the cherry in the middle with
uh-huh.
the cream filling in a bottle.
Wow.
Way to go.
Not very expensive.
If you really like it, we can give it to you in a box.
In a box.
But it
now,
really is a well-made product.
And when you, now talk, tell our viewers again, there is a very important message when you get the wine that's in the box. It stays fresher longer.
It stays fresher longer. That is, if you want something that's going to last and maintain its integrity, typically if you can find it in a box,
mm-hmm.
this is a more practical way
to do it.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Yeah, you bet.
Okay.
Then on the other side are the traditional good quality, good high-end, medium-end, low-end, but still well-made, Cabernet, Chardonnay.
Well, let's take a walk over there.
This is where we have our discerning palates coming to spend time with us.
Okay.
These are the Pinot Noirs, the Merlots, very active set of shelves here in our store.
Mm-hmm.
If you're looking for an all-purpose red, you don't know if it's going to be for dinner or without, or you're just even looking to give something nice to someone, the Pinot Noirs are a good choice because they tend to be a bit more versatile.
Yes, I do like that as well.
Yeah, they're the way to go for something that's going to give you all of the points of a world-class wine, even if you don't really know which direction you're going with.
Exactly.
It. And then behind you over here, these are the Cabernet. This is dinner time wine.
Okay.
A lot of folks like to drink them just by the glass, but usually the key is for matching up with the
meal.
Meat and potatoes.
There you go.
Meat and potatoes.
Absolutely.
And then on the other side are the blended red wines,
okay.
high quality American, and red Zinfandel.
I love some Zinfandel as well.
Yeah, people are always, a lot of folks are still surprised to say, I thought it was pink. Real Zinfandel is red, and real Zinfandel is a work of art in itself, an area of personal interest of mine. But we're getting a lot of well-made blended wines, which are a combination of 2, 3, 4 even or more grapes. This is a real growth category.
Okay.
Some of your real surprises are right here in this section, and usually it's something you've never heard of before.
True, lots of information. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to take our next break, and we're going to get ready to now talk about the good old suds. You're going to show us some beers. So y'all stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Welcome back to the show, and as promised, we're here to talk to you now about some beers that they have and some other things back here in the back of the store, and we're going to walk in, I think you called it a man cooler, or... Person cooler?
It's a beer cave. It's
a
not
beer
a man cave, although some folks would say they are synonymous.
I can't wait to see this. Okay, so what do we have now? If we've already talked about the others. We got some beer.
30 cold doors.
Oh, my gosh.
And even though this actually is beer land, the first couple of doors are chilled wines, including champagnes for New Year's. It'll be well stocked. Come on down.
Yeah, so if you want it already chilled, it's already done here.
Ready to go.
Okay, and but so as we walk down the beer wall.
From here on down, we're getting into craft beers, flavored beers.
Mm-hmm.
Some very popular domestically produced sweet water.
Local.
Sweetwater and Terrapin are George's homegrown and big success stories, not just here, but across the country.
Absolutely.
And then, of course, Sam Adams.
Yeah.
But once you get past those guys, there is a wealth of brands that no one's probably ever heard of unless you're just really into craft brews.
Right.
And some of these guys are really up and coming and very successful, very high quality.
What a selection.
We're into world-class beers these days.
Very, very big selection here.
And then, of course,
you got your Corona.
Imports from around the world. Corona, Guinness, Heineken, Amstel, Stella Artois.
Your Japanese beer.
Asahi, my personal favorite, Kirin.
Mm-hmm.
But here we have something that's really inspired a lot of our customers. You can come in and on these shelves we stack all kinds of individual bottles. And just come in and grab a 138 six-pack.
Okay.
And this way you can put together your own sampler, one of each, and figure out which ones you really wanted to come back for a whole six-pack of.
Wow, that is interesting. So it gives them the opportunity to sample
imports,
different types of beers.
Domestics and crafts, we mix the pot here very well. But there's a tremendous selection that you can have a lot of fun with.
That's great. That's great.
One of our newest and
local
success stories here in Clayton County, Georgia.
Yes, sir. Hampton, absolutely. And I was just going to ask you about that. Do you happen to have in stock yet on the shelf Jailhouse? We're very proud of that.
Including conjugal visit.
There you go. Gotta drive on down and get you some of that. Try it out. Are we walking into the cooler now?
This is the man cave. Oh, I meant to say beer cave.
I was about to say, am I allowed to go in here? Of course I am.
This is where you can grab your own case.
Wow.
Or 18 packs, 30 packs of whatever you like, cold and in quantity. That's the idea.
And the customers can come in on their own. They do not have to have permission to walk in here.
Yeah, come on in, make yourself at home. With a temperature like this, I don't think you'll hang around very long.
Okay, so now, Bill, I see that we still have some eggnog here from the holidays. Y'all usually keep eggnog in for a while, or?
We have a problem with eggnog. It seems like we can never really get enough.
Oh, my goodness.
So we bring in as much as we can so that we'll hopefully have some left over after the first of the year, which we usually do. People ask for it all the way up into the springtime.
It's only
available at the beginning of the holidays.
There you go. So you always get extra.
As much as we can.
Want some more of that eggnog? Come on down and get it.
Yeah, we should have some left over. We hope we do.
That'll be good. Now, there are some other things that you wanted to talk about. First, I wanted to ask you, these are little small sampler size?
You know, when we started out, we were talking about the tremendous explosion in flavors and vodkas and gins and rums. But here again, people don't realize how much of these are available in sampler sizes if you really want to, you know, check it out.
So that you can actually see what it is that you're tasting before you make that big investment.
Yeah.
And over here are some more samplers that you have.
There's a galaxy of them, and they're not too shabby for traveling either.
If you've got a favorite,
you're not sure you're going to be able to find it where you're going.
Now, this is vodka.
Yeah.
And it's whipped, like whipped cream. What would you put this in?
Who'd have thunk, right?
I know. You just drink that straight. Oh, my goodness. Okay. And all right. And then we've got some more samplers around the side.
And you can, they're not just flavors. There actually are the 50 milliliter sizes available in all of the standard go-to items in your liquors, your American whiskeys, even the scotches. There again, very handy for taking with you when you're on the go. because this is Atlanta. Everybody's from somewhere and going somewhere else.
You're so right.
Just toss them in your bag and off you go. You don't have to have a fifth of something when you really you only need a little bit.
Small amount.
You bet.
Okay, well, when I came in to visit with you today, I wanted to talk about New Year's Eve. Of course, New Year's Eve is right around the corner, and a lot of people like to be responsible by celebrating at home. And when you celebrate at home, and just because you're not a bartender or may not have one, you can come in and talk to the virtual bartender, and she'll be able to help you out with what you may be looking for. We've given all kinds of opportunities for you, but the one thing that we want to make sure that we share is being responsible and safe driving should you be out, and there's a program you want to discuss.
We do several things that are, you know, geared towards benefiting the public as a business, but we are partners with Safe Ride Atlanta.
Okay.
And that's a Safe Ride service where if you're out in the public, you don't trust yourself to drive, you can call Safe Ride Atlanta, and there are a lot of bars and restaurants that are well familiar with the program, where they provide, if necessary, at no cost to you, transportation home for you and your vehicle.
Now, I have actually spoken to them before to get educational information about the company, and I will tell you that it's true. If you are out and about, and you may have had too much to drink, but you need to get a ride home, they'll take your car home, too.
Yep.
And if you don't have the cash on you at that moment, then you can pay them later.
You can pay them later. Talk about full service.
Absolutely. Well, it's all about being safe. It's all about being safe. What other people did you want to discuss?
We do other things. We also, several times a year, hold events that benefit Arts Clayton, which benefits the arts programs in the Clayton Public Schools. And we also benefit a support home, a halfway house for unwed mothers known as the House of Dawn. We have an annual event for them as well. So, you know, the whole world, the whole community comes walking through our doors, and so we have more of a relationship than just selling something to drink.
Sure, and that's what we want you to know, and we want you to continue to support Highway 138 Bottle Shop, of course, conveniently located right here off Highway 138 when you get off I-75. Come in and see them and get the things that you need for your New Year's party. And remember, they give back to the community tremendously. So we want to wish you a very happy New Year. And thank you for tuning in and being a part of our show. And thank you so much for having us today.
Highway 138, the name tells the story.
There you go. Y'all have a great and safe New Year. We'll see you again next time.
Happy New Year.